Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I would have died, but I would have never finished my salat. Such was the concentration in their salat. And so, respected brothers and elders, we have to make this effort and this whole ijtima, if we ponder upon all the talks that all the elders have given, the crux of the matter is we have to make an effort to bring the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala into our lives. And we have to strengthen our iman so that we fall in love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we start offering our salat, so that deen and Islam becomes a major part of our lives, so that we start following the sunnahs of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so we start aspiring for paradise, so we start detaching ourselves from the comforts of this world, we start striving out in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we start yearning for the hereafter, yearning for the paradise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for us. This person standing at the gate of Jannah, the angel will say to him that this is just the gate, go inside. So he'll start going inside. When he goes inside, somebody will come to greet him. It says in the riwayat that this person that will come to greet him will be so beautiful, so handsome, that the person, we guys who are going into Jannah, will have never seen anything like it. So we will fall into sajda. So the angels will come, this person will come and tap him on the shoulder and tell him to stand up. He said, what are you doing? Lima sajadta, why did you do sajda? So he says, because you are my Allah. I had heard in the world, laysa kamithlihi shay. Allah is the most beautiful. Nothing is as beautiful as Allah. And I have never seen anything or anyone more beautiful than you. You are my Allah who has come to welcome me. That's why I done sajda to you. So this angel will laugh and he says, no, I'm not your Lord. I'm not your Allah. Inni malakun kareem. I'm just an angel. The lowest angel from the millions of angels that Allah Ta'ala has created to serve you in your Jannah, I am the lowest angel. You think I'm beautiful? Go ahead and look at the other angels. So the person will go ahead, and the second person to come greet him, he will fall into sajda again. And they'll laugh and they'll tap him on the shoulder and say, get up. So what are you doing? He said, you're my Allah. I said, no. He said, there's millions of servants in your paradise. I am the lowest of the servants to serve you in your paradise. You think I'm beautiful? Go check out the other servants. And he'll go ahead and he'll fall into sajda again. And the angels will lift him up and say, no, I'm just an angel. Your Allah is inside your paradise. If you think I'm beautiful, we're beautiful, go check out your paradise. And go check out your Allah who is the creator of your paradise. Imagine what beauty which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for us. And this person will keep on going inside. Then there come the hoors of Jannah, the women of Jannah, about which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, so beautiful that if one woman from Jannah, from the hoors of Jannah, the damsels of Jannah, she's so beautiful, if she was to enter her fingertip from the skies into this world, this fingertip would outshine the sun, illuminate the whole world. If she was to spit into the oceans of this world, the salty oceans would become sweet. So beautiful. If she was to go in front of a dead person would come back to life. If she was to dangle one hair into this world, the whole world would fill up with fragrance. Such are the ni'mat of paradise, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for us, provided we do not follow our desires. We sacrifice our desires and we strive in the path of Allah for the cause of Allah, and we sacrifice ourselves for the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we follow the blessed ways of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I'll end with one example that the elders give. Our example in the world today, how has it become? People may be offended, I apologize in advance, but my situation is such. And many people are in this situation. We have hankered after the dunya, after the world, thinking our success is in this. In Urdu we say, Daam Banaye Kaam. In English we say, money talks. If you have wealth, all my problems will be solved. This is an ill inside us. This is what is wrong with our iman. Hazrat Molana Yusuf Sahib Rahmatullah used to say, we've heard from the elders, that if you get an idol made of gold, a big idol, a Buddha, and you put it in front of Muslims, or first of all, if you say to the Muslims that bow down in front of this idol, worship this